The Rise of China. 2 centuries ago, Napoleon warned, "Let China sleep. When she wakes, she will shake the world." The Rise of China will undoubtedly be one of the great dramas of the 21st century. China's extraordinary economic growth and active diplomacy are already transforming East Asia, and further decades will see even greater increases in Chinese power and influence. As part of a brand new mini documentary series, KJ Vids is extremely excited to kick off its new video series that will explore the rise of China. But before we begin, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and alerts to receive notifications for our latest videos, as well as like and share our video. Also, feel free to post a comment with your thoughts. Now, in this episode, we will look only at the sheer size of China today. We will then look at its threats, challenges, and confrontations with America in future episodes. In 1980, China's gross domestic product, GDP, was less than $300 billion. By 2015, it was $11 trillion, making it the world's second largest economy by market exchange rates. China's trade with the outside world in 1980 amounted to less than $40 billion. By 2015, it had increased 100-fold to a whopping $4 trillion. Even at its lower growth rate in 2015, China's economy created a Greece every 16 weeks and an Israel every 25 weeks. Measured by purchasing power parity, which measures how many aircraft, missiles, ships, sailors, pilots, drones, bases, and other military-related items a state can buy, and the prices it has to pay in its own national currency, China has not only surpassed the US, but also now accounts for roughly 18% of world GDP, compared to just 2% in 1980. By 2005, the country was building the square foot equivalent of today's Rome every 2 weeks. Between 2011 and 2013, China both produced and used more cement than the US did in the entire 20th century. In 2011, a Chinese firm built a 30-story skyscraper in just 15 days. 3 years later, another construction firm built a 57-story skyscraper in 19 days. China so far has built the equivalent of Europe's entire housing stock in just 15 years. In November 2015, Beijing replaced the substantially larger 1,300-ton San Juan Bridge in just 43 hours. Between 1996 and 2016, China has built 2.6 million miles of roads, including 70,000 miles of highways, connecting 95% of the country's villages and overtaking the US as the country with the most extensive highway system by almost 50%. Over the past decade, China has constructed the world's longest high-speed rail network, 12,000 miles of rail lines that carry passengers between cities at speeds of up to 180 miles per hour. China now has more high-speed rail tracks than the rest of the world combined. In stark contrast, during this same decade, California has been struggling mightily to build a single 520-mile high-speed connection between Los Angeles and San Francisco. Voters approved the project in 2008, but the state recently admitted it will not be finished until 2029 at a cost of $68 billion. 9 years later, and $35 billion more than was originally promised. By then, China plans to have completed another 16,000 miles of high-speed rail connections. China's education, healthcare, and related indicators reflect similar improvements in its people's well-being. In 1949, Chinese citizens could expect to die at the age of 36, and 8 in 10 could not read or write. By 2014, life expectancy had more than doubled to 76, and 95% are literate. A generation ago, China stood at the bottom of most international rankings of nations in education, science, technology, and innovation. But after 2 decades of determined investment in the country's human capital, it has become a global competitor. Today, it rivals and by some measures outperforms the United States. On the 2015 Program for International Student Assessment, China ranked 6th in mathematics, while the United States ranked 39th. China's score was well above the OECD average, while the US score was significantly below. Even the highest-rated American state, Massachusetts, would stand just 20th if it were measured as its own country in the rankings, a drop from its 9th place rating when the test was last conducted in 2012. According to the most recent Stanford University comparison of students entering college in the fields of engineering and computer science, Chinese high school graduates arrive with a 3-year advantage over their American counterparts in critical thinking skills. In 2015, Tsinghua University passed MIT in the US News and World Report rankings to become the number one university in the world for engineering. Among the top 10 schools of engineering, China and the US each had 4. In STEM subjects, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, which provide the core competencies driving advances in science, technology, and the fastest growing sectors of modern economies, China annually graduates 4 times as many students as the US, 1.3 million versus 300,000, and that does not even include an additional 300,000 Chinese students currently enrolled in US institutions. Long known primarily as a low-cost producer of inexpensive consumer goods, China has seen its share of total global value added in high-tech manufacturing increase from 7% in 2003 to 27% in 2014. The US National Science Foundation report that documented this growth also finds that over that same decade, the American share of this market declined from 36% to 29%. For example, in the fast-moving field of robotics in 2015, China not only registered twice as many applications for new patents, but also added 2.5 times as many industrial robots to its workforce. On its current path, China will surpass the US to become the world leader in research and development spending by 2019. Since June 2013, the world's fastest supercomputer has been located not in Silicon Valley, but in China. Indeed, in the rankings of the world's 500 fastest supercomputers, a list from which China was absent in 2001, today it has 167, 2 more than the United States. Moreover, China's top supercomputer is 5 times faster than the closest American competitor. And while China's supercomputers previously relied heavily on American processors, its top computer in 2016 was built entirely with domestic processors. As China's economy has gotten bigger, its guns and tanks and their 21st century equivalents have gotten better and allowed for a new level of competition with other great powers, especially the United States. Just as technology startups like Facebook and Uber have used the concept of disruptive innovation to upend previously dominant firms, the Chinese military is developing new technologies that can counter ships, planes, and satellites that the US has developed over decades and for a fraction of the cost. Today, states playing catch-up need not replicate investments that their competitors made in hardware and other legacy platforms. New technologies allow for asymmetric responses, like missiles that can be launched from the Chinese mainland to destroy aircraft carriers, or anti-satellite weapons that for $1 million can destroy a multi-billion dollar US satellite. According to figures provided by CIPRI, China has increased its defense spending nearly fivefold over the last decade. China currently spends more on defense than Japan, South Korea, the Philippines, and Vietnam combined, and China's military spending is second only to the United States. China is now building a blue water navy. A green water navy patrols its maritime borders. A blue water navy patrols the oceans. It will take another 30 years, assuming economic progression, for China to build naval capacity to seriously challenge the most powerful seaborne force the world has ever seen, the US Navy. But in the medium to short term, as it builds and trains and learns, the Chinese Navy will bump up against its rivals in the sea, and how those bumps are managed, especially the Sino-American ones, will define great power politics in this century. China intends to become a two-ocean power, Pacific and Indian. To achieve this, China is investing in deepwater ports in Burma, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka, an investment which buys it good relations, the potential for its future navy to have friendly bases to visit or reside in, and trade links back home. In 2014, China inaugurated a major international economic development program by financing infrastructure projects in the historical Silk Route countries. It is engaged in financing economic infrastructure projects in the Silk Route countries with positive ROI for China and the recipient countries. The Chinese are also building ports in Kenya, railway lines in Angola, and a hydroelectric dam in Ethiopia. They are scouring the length and breadth of the whole of Africa for minerals and precious metals. So guys, that's a little glimpse as to why many analysts are talking about the rise of China. But what are its threats and challenges? Has it got the potential to overtake America as the number one power? We will look into these questions in future episodes. In the meantime, thanks for watching our video, and don't forget to like, share, and comment on our video. And please do subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with our content.